Good morning, all people. Welcome to our Sunday morning worship experience. Thanks for joining us on today. Make sure you like, comment, and share this broadcast with your family and friends. Join us on Wednesdays at 6 p.m. for Fire the Word virtual Bible study. Pastor Walter Hall and Minister Chantel Cross will continue the series on overcoming fear right here on Facebook Live. All people, it's that time of year again for our annual rice drive for Haiti. A 100-pound sack is only $40. Let's continue to be a blessing to our partners in Haiti. You can donate via Cash App at $APICJAX or visit us on Givelify. Make sure you indicate Haiti Rice Drive. Call in all seniors. Join us every Sunday evening at 5 p.m. for our senior prayer call. Everyone is welcome to join in. Next food giveaway will be on Tuesday, August the 24th at 11 a.m. Join Bishop Sharon Jones every Wednesday at noon for It's Another Time to Pray Noonday Edition on Facebook Live. Please sow into our ministry on this morning. There are three ways to do so. The first way to give is through our website, www.allpeopleint.org. Click on the Giving tab and give. The second way to give is through Givelify. Type in All People International Church. Our zip code is 32208. You'll see a picture of our leaders, Chief Apostle Octi Jones Sr. and Bishop Sharon Jones. The third way to give is via Cash App. Our Cash App handle is $APICJAX. Let's give honor to our leaders, Chief Apostle Octi Jones Sr. and Bishop Sharon Jones. We thank you and honor you both, and we appreciate all you do in ministry. We love you! Pastor Ardale Jones and Pastor Walter Hall, thank you both for all you do in ministry. We love you. Get ready. Our Sunday morning worship experience starts now.
Thank you. time again. And our bishop so often says, if you did it before, he'll do it again. You just have to trust and believe
that bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Come on, saints, put your hands together. Amen. Our God is an awesome God. Can you testify that we serve an awesome we serve an awesome God? Hallelujah. Can you just worship the Lord with me on this morning? Hallelujah. If God has been good to you, you sitting here today, you are alive. Hallelujah. We didn't view you. I don't care how you're feeling, you've got something to praise God for. Can you just open your mouth, hallelujah, and just give God a praise? I can't praise him for you, and you can't praise him for me, but we've got to open our mouths and praise God, hallelujah. Can I hear you give God a praise? Amen, amen. You may be seated, amen.
There's nobody like our God.
Nobody like.
You may be wondering why the setting has changed.
Hallelujah.
My pulpit was designed for my height. And when I sat down behind it, I look like a midget now.
Yes. Just disappear.
And so you can see more of us, more of me. We did this. And we're also ordering a new pulpit. A little change, a little different stuff. I love you. How many feel blessed of God?
Blessed.
If you're in love with God, I want you to jump on your feet and sit back down.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir, Bishop. Yes, yes, yes.
Nobody like our God.
Nobody like him.
Our virtual members, those who visit us by Facebook, God bless you.
God glad bless to have you this with morning. Us. Amen.
And those who are here present, God bless you.
Amen.
You look good to me.
Amen.
Well, I know it's a little warm in here today. We're trying to get the chillers worked on and making some decisions about some things. They said it's going to, get this, they say it's going to be about 6 months before we can get all the parts together. Ain't that something? Because of the pandemic and everything is short and what they have to do, but we all right.
Amen.
You're not burned up in here.
No, sir.
It's nice in here.
Amen.
And I thank God for that. God knows how to keep things straight. Well,
yes, sir.
Bishop, let me say this. I thank God so much for God giving my wife back her strength.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
She started fussing at me again about what I eat. Taking salt from me.
Yes.
And I say it in my heart, thank you, God, she's back. Because she hadn't been doing that.
Praise God.
I'm so honored.
Yes.
I'm so honored to have you.
God bless you, Bishop.
And the opportunity to love you and to care for you and to protect you.
God bless you.
You're my girl.
Amen.
This is my first lady. You may call her first lady, but she is in essence my first lady. She's my love, my friend, my worst critic, and my greatest amen. And I appreciate God for
God bless you.
You. Well,
God bless you.
There is a word
yes.
from the Lord.
Yes, yes. Won't you turn your Bibles with us this morning to St. John, the 19th chapter. St. John 19, verses 28 through 30. Amen. Again, that's St. John 19, 28 through 30. And it says this, after this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, saith, I thirst. Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar, and put it upon hyssop, and put it to his mouth. And your attention is drawn to verse 30. When Jesus, therefore, had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost.
God bless you, saints. We want to talk.
Yes.
To teach. Perhaps preach from the subject, it is finished.
Yes, yes.
Let us pray.
Hallelujah.
O eternal and everlasting Father.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Our hearts are ever humbled before you.
Hallelujah.
And God, we give to you all the praise, glory, and honor that we can give you. And yet, it is not enough.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
We honor you. We bless your holy name.
Yes.
And we stand, God, before your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Saying thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We thank you, God, that through this coronavirus, we thank you, God, that through this coronavirus, that thou hast blessed us. And you, God, have helped us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Saints in this sanctuary.
Hallelujah.
And those who are in our virtual church.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you lift your hands?
Hallelujah.
And tell God thank you.
Thank you, God.
God, we don't play church.
My Jesus. Thank you.
Neither do we act out parts. But our hearts are real before you. And we say thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, God, upon a word today,
yes,
that will touch the hearts of those who hear. And God, bless us.
Bless us, God.
And let our faith, our trust in you, ever grow. In the precious name
thank
of
you,
Jesus.
Thank
now, Lord God, reclaim backsliders.
Yes, God.
Let those who are weak be made strong. And Lord God, I pray in the precious name of Jesus,
thank you, Jesus.
That you, God, would give to each of us strength for the journey.
Yes, Lord.
It is our prayer and our faith.
Thank you.
Now God calls my wife and I to decrease.
Yes, yes, yes.
That your anointing, your power might increase in us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Do it, God.
Do it, God.
And we give you praise, glory, and honor. And we say thank God in Jesus' name. Amen. This 30th verse is the sixth of the seven last words that Jesus spoke on the cross.
Yes.
And of all the words he spoke,
yes, sir.
These three words,
mm-hmm.
It is finished,
yes.
Was the most important of all his last words.
Yes, sir, Bishop.
Not only was it the most important, but it was the most touching to the heart.
Yes.
When you consider all that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, endured,
yes, sir.
That we might be saved.
We might be saved.
From heaven's throne,
yes.
To the cross, he did for us what no one else or anything could do.
Hallelujah.
And he did it.
Yes.
For you.
Yes, yes, yes.
And
yes.
For me.
Hey, saints, because we were separated from God. Hallelujah. Can you just lift your hands and tell the Lord Jesus, thank you for giving us another chance.
Yes.
We were separated from God. We were lost.
Yes.
We were dead in sin and without hope.
Yes.
But these three words, somebody say these three words. It is finished, spoke to whatever we would
yes.
face in our life. These three words, it is finished, spoke to our sinful condition. These three words, it is finished, spoke to every temptation. It spoke to what you're going through right now.
Yes.
I know somebody is going through right now. You're going through something, but that it is finished was for every pain. Every hurt,
yes.
Every issue that you would experience in your life, what Jesus did on the cross, nobody could do that
nobody.
But him. No she-goats, and you hear bishops say it all the time, no she-goats, no heifers, no donkeys, no bullocks could do it. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Somebody say nothing but the blood of
nothing
Jesus.
But the blood of
nothing
Jesus.
Could do what he could do. What can wash away my sin? I love that praise. Sister Jose, I love it. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of
yes.
Jesus. What can make me whole again?
Nothing
but
the blood
of Jesus. Oh, how precious.
Yes.
Oh, how precious is that flow that makes us white as snow. Nothing could do it for us but the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
It took
the precious
blood of Jesus
precious blood.
To carry our sins to the cross.
Yes, yes.
To
yes.
carry our hurts to the cross.
Yes, sir, Bishop.
To carry our pains to the cross.
Precious blood.
To carry our sicknesses.
Hallelujah.
Be it spiritual.
Yes.
Mental.
Yes, sir.
Or physical.
Yes.
Every pain that we deal with in life, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ
yes,
took it to the cross.
Took it to the cross.
And to end it in our lives.
Woo.
If we can trust the work
yes.
that he's done.
Yes, sir.
He
yes,
has
sir.
Done it for us.
Yes, sir.
He has done it for us.
Yes, sir.
And if you today could just trust him.
Just trust him.
I want to say it again. Just trust him.
Yes.
Sometimes it's hard to trust people because you've been deceived and lied to so much.
Yes, sir.
But you can't stop trusting.
My Lord.
Listen to me. The only way you're going to find out if you can trust someone is to trust them.
All right.
And I can assure you today from the self-experience that I've had
Hallelujah.
That if you can just trust the Lord,
trust him.
First of all, he will never desert you. He'll never
right.
leave you.
All right.
Secondly, he will never at any time
Jesus.
Forsake you.
My God.
Sometimes people you are counting on,
yes.
who you're trusting,
yes, sir.
At the very time you need them, there have been other times you really didn't need them, they were there. But the very time that you need them,
yes.
they weren't there.
My God.
They forsake you. But he will never forsake
never
you.
Forsake. Hallelujah.
But most of all, saints,
glory to God.
I don't care how much people committed to you
My God.
And how much they care about you
yes.
and how often they are there with you. There's one promise they cannot make.
My Lord.
They cannot say from their heart and be truthful, I'll never fail you.
All right.
Because we are human
yes.
and full of human faults and limitations. But God has no limitation.
And you know what, Bishop? We've got to understand that people are human.
Yes.
I don't care how much they want to do, they are human. And sometimes they just can't do, and you can't hate them.
Can't hate them.
No, you got to keep on loving them and keep on praying for
yes.
them. But the only one, just like Bishop said, the only one that
yes.
we can trust and lean on and take him at his word is our Lord. Because the Lord said he's not man that he lie. He can't lie. Look at your neighbor.
Yes.
If it's a way across the room, say, our God can't lie.
God
if God
lie.
Said he's going to do it,
yes.
he's going to do it. And what we've got to do,
yes.
we've got to trust him at his word.
Trust him.
Yes.
At his word.
We've got to trust
I
him.
I wish I had
Thank you, God.
Somebody
yes, sir, Bishop.
To shout, it is finished.
It is finished.
Because of what God
Woo.
Allowed his son Jesus Christ
yes, sir.
To do for you on
yes.
the cross.
Yes.
I want to say this. Every trial,
My God.
Every hurt,
yes, sir.
Every pain,
yes.
every difficulty, every hard decision, every tear you cry today or tomorrow, God allowed his son Jesus to take it to the cross
yes.
and to end that in your life
Ooh,
if you can only trust him.
Yes.
Can I hear somebody say, I trust him.
I trust him.
I trust him.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
The Lord had us to put these bulletins on the walls.
Yes, sir.
Trust God.
Trust God.
All things are possible to him that believeth.
Yes.
If you can trust God.
Trust him.
To believe that God will keep his word.
Hallelujah.
That God will do for you what he said he would do.
Yes.
God is obligated. By his own word, and he don't have to police his word.
Hello.
His word is absolute.
Absolutely.
If he says it, it's so.
Hallelujah.
If he says it, it's done.
Yes,
he ain't got to go back and ask his word. Did you do what I said? But when God says his word out, he says He will not allow his word to return to him void.
Yes.
He said, my word must accomplish my pleasure.
Yes, sir.
And prosper the things whereunto I said it. Mm. So when God sends his word out, it's going to accomplish. I want to say this to you. Every prayer you pray.
Yes, sir.
Every request you made in faith and trust in God, God has already answered that prayer.
Hallelujah.
The problem with receiving the answer is our ability to trust him.
Yes, sir.
If you can't trust God with an absolute mind, the Bible says, but without faith,
yes,
it's impossible to please the Lord. But he that cometh to God,
yes,
must first believe that is to know that he is, and that he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Yes,
so I came to tell you today, you got to trust him.
Got to trust him.
To get something.
Yes, sir.
I'll say it again. You got to trust him.
Got to trust
to get what you want. And God is asking us the question.
Jesus.
Can God trust you?
Yes.
To trust him.
Hallelujah.
Can God trust you to trust him? Mm. I don't care what it is. I want to ask a question. If you got something in you, I want you to stand to your feet. Is there anybody in here that needs God to do something for you?
My
stand
Lord.
To your feet.
Hallelujah. Yes, 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 yes.
Now sit back down.
Woo, hallelujah.
I got another question for you. Mm. Are you trusting God to do it? My if you are, stand to your feet.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Can I ask this while you're standing?
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you trust God in spite of
my God
the difficulties?
Yes, sir.
The hurts?
Yes.
The pains? The disappointments?
Yes.
Can you trust God?
Woo.
When it just looks like it ain't gonna work?
My Lord.
Can you trust God enough to dance in the storms,
hey,
and the rains that come on your life?
Yes,
can you just listen to the sea? Can you just trust God?
Just trust God.
If you can't, say it loud. I trust God.
I trust God. You know, saints, you may be seated, but it seems as though that is the universal word now,
yes,
that preachers are preaching all over the land. Can you trust God?
Yes.
That's the word that's coming. Can you trust God? You may feel broken right now. You may feel lost and can't see your way.
Yes.
But if you can just trust God and trust his word, let me tell you, if you can just trust,
yes,
God, yes, it is hard. Yes, what we're going through is hard.
Yes,
yes, what's happening right now is hard.
Yes.
But can you trust God?
Yes.
Trusting God when you don't understand. Trusting God when you can't see your way.
Yes.
Trusting God when everything seems like it's against you.
Yes.
Trusting God when it feels like nobody cares.
Yes.
Trusting God when you feel like you're all by yourself.
Yes. Somebody.
Can you trust,
yes,
him? We've got to learn how to trust God. Trust God. We've got to trust him. Trust him, trust him, trust him. We've got to trust in the Lord with all our hearts and lean not. I love that scripture. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into thine own understanding. In all thy ways, everything you do. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. God, is it all right to do this? God, should I do this? God, should I go that direction? God, should I, in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Yes, you're dealing with issues. Anybody not dealing with something, stand to your feet. Let me say that again. Listen to what I'm saying. That's right. I'm giving all y'all a chance to sit down. Anybody that's not dealing with anything, I want you to stand on your feet. Ah, yeah, because I was going to come to you and ask you what your secret is.
Yes, yes.
Because every one of us are dealing with something. But our hope, everyone is dealing with something.
Yes, yes.
But all of our hope, our faith, and our trust must be in the Lord,
yes,
and what he has already. Throw your hand up and say, it is finished.
It is finished.
You know, I went through something. I want to give just this short testimony.
Give it,
I went through
give
something
it.
In my body. Never gone through anything like that before in my life.
Yes.
70 years old. I've never experienced anything like that. And I shut down. Never experienced anything like that before in my life.
I got tired. I thank God for all of your praying because it was the effectual, fervent prayers of the righteous
yes.
that brought me through. Devil told me you're going to die. You're getting ready to leave here. God said it ain't your time yet.
Yes.
I remember talking to God. I said, God, I'm tired
yes.
of this. I said, Lord, whatever it is, whatever lesson I was supposed to learn in this.
Yes.
I said, God, I've learned it. That's yes. what I told the Lord. I said, God, whatever lesson I'm supposed to learn so I can help some young woman get through this in her life. God, I've learned yes. it. I said, okay, God, I'm tired of this now. Tired of it.
Yes.
Bishop should have preached this message a long time ago. It is finished. Because I would have known just exactly what to say to it. I would have said, it is finished. I'm not shy. But yes. guess what? God came in. God touched my body. Started feeling myself again.
Yes.
Wasn't feeling like myself. Hey. But God touched me. And all you've got to do is trust God. Oh, you've got somebody going through something right now. I want you to stand up to your feet and shout, it is finished.
It is finished. Yes, yes.
It's finished.
It's finished.
It's over. God, whatever lesson I was supposed to learn from it, I've learned it.
Yes.
I've learned it. If I'm supposed to testify and tell it, like since I've been going through, I've been talking to young women.
Yes.
God going to take you through. Man, God going to
take you through.
But it is finished. And every one of us are dealing with something. Logan, I know you're dealing with something,
yes.
baby. With them people at that school, I know it.
Yes.
But God going to take you through.
Yes.
God's going to help you. How do we pray for you every morning? I know your mama and your grandmama pray for you. I know it. But uncle
yes.
and auntie praying for you too.
Yes.
We call out y'all's name because I know you're good. The devil is pulling over
not,
you.
Not just sometimes.
I'm not sure. Glory to
but
God.
Every morning.
Yes.
After our corporate prayer.
My God.
Bishop Sharon and myself bow down and call your name out.
Yes.
And your house.
That's right.
We do it.
We do it.
And we do that faithfully.
Faithful.
Because we trust God. To hear our words, we have dealt with many issues
yes.
in our married life.
Hallelujah.
52 years. In those 52 years, we have been church people.
Yes, yes, yes.
Issues, concerns, difficulties, heaviness,
yes,
weights, yokes. But I can't tell you one time that God gave up on us. I can't tell you one time
Hallelujah.
That God somehow, some way, opened a door
yes, Lord.
And made a way.
Made a way.
Because in my heart, though I fell short sometimes, though I know I disappointed God sometimes,
yes,
I still trusted
still
God.
Trust.
I still believed God. I said, God, strengthen me.
Yes, God.
And God strengthened me.
Yes.
I said, God, help me. And God helped me.
Yes.
I said, God, deliver me. And God delivered me.
Hallelujah.
I said, God, give me the victory.
Yes.
And God gave to us the victory. I tell you this,
yes.
God is forever faithful.
Faithful.
If we're willing to trust him in spite of,
yes,
I dare somebody to jump to your feet. Point a finger at somebody and say, come on.
Come on.
Let's trust God.
Let's trust God. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The victory
Woo.
Is already ours.
Already ours.
The debt
yes, sir.
Has already been paid.
Already been paid.
The sin
yes.
has already been blotted out.
Yes, sir.
We are free.
Free.
From that sin.
Hallelujah.
From that iniquity.
Yeah.
If we can just trust him.
Trust him.
The victory
yes.
has already been won. Not for Jesus. Not for heaven.
Hallelujah.
For heaven would still be there. Jesus still be there.
Yes,
but the victory
yes,
was won by Jesus
yes, yes.
for us.
For us.
He
yeah.
who knew no sin,
no sin
became sin for us.
Yes, sir.
The Bible says, God prepared a body for Jesus
yes, yes.
and sent him to earth and for sin,
yes,
condemn sin in the flesh. And the Bible says we have not a high priest who cannot be touched by the feelings of our infirmity.
All right.
But in every point, he was tempted as we.
Everything
but he came out without sin.
Yes, sir.
Teaching us that denying ungodliness,
yes,
and worldly lust,
yes,
we can live soberly and righteously in this present world.
Yes, sir.
We can live it.
Live it.
We can please God in this present world. Mm. Thus, if sin can be eliminated,
hallelujah,
through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, everything that sin brought is washed out. The sickness, the hurt, the guilt, the defeat, every issue,
yes,
that sin brought on the cross, that place of skull, Calvary's mountain,
yes,
son,
sir,
when Jesus' blood ran down, it healed us.
Yes.
It delivered us.
Yes.
But it will not work. You know,
hallelujah,
this is just talking. Got a letter from the bank. Got $1 million sitting up in there. But I got to have enough trust to go and sign the papers to get my money.
My Lord.
If I never go to get what's mine, I'll never have it.
Never have it.
God has given you the victory.
My God.
He's finished it.
Yes.
He sealed it with his own blood.
Hallelujah.
Initiated and sealed, yes, with his own blood. You know, when great painters finish their masterpiece, mm-hmm, the last thing they do is sign it.
Yes.
When men who compose music, great composers, when they finish a great composition, they sign it.
Yes.
Jesus has finished the work of salvation.
Hallelujah.
To bring us back to him, his Father,
yes,
in the presence of his Spirit. With his
own blood,
he paid the price.
Yes.
And all he wants out of you is to trust his, yes, work enough, trust the truth of his word enough,
yes,
to come and say, Lord,
hallelujah,
give it to me.
Yes, sir.
Lord, give me the blessings. Lord, give me, how many, are you tired of being broken down? Are you tired of being defeated? How many in the church speaking in tongue, preaching and singing, but down in your heart you feel defeated? God never intended for you to be defeated or brought down. Every day you wake up, you want to go back to sleep because you can't see nothing tomorrow. God, let me tell you something. God's got a bright future for you.
Sir.
God's got a, can I get a witness?
Yes,
can you point a finger at somebody,
sir,
and say, God's got a bright,
God's
future for you.
Bright future for you.
And all you got to do is to accept that fact and go running after it.
My God.
The Bible said faith,
yes,
our trust,
yes,
is dead without works.
That's right.
You got to work your trust in God. You got to work your faith in God. You got to believe that God's going to do what he said he going to do.
Hallelujah.
You never had a baby, but you want a baby.
My Jesus.
You got to start fixing up the baby room because God promised you'll have it.
Hallelujah.
You got to go start buying some baby clothes. You know, Bishop Sharon and I were married for over 2 years, and she couldn't get pregnant. I came one day for work, and I saw her crying, and I said, what's wrong, baby? She said, we've been married 2 years, and I want a baby, and I can't get pregnant. Me and her got on our knees that very day,
amen,
and start praying,
amen,
trusting that God could do it.
Amen.
And I said, God, my wife wants a child. I want a child.
Yes.
I said, God, give to us a baby.
Yes.
Then I said, God, you know you can talk to God. I said, God, I'd like to have a boy. I said it. I said, a boy child. And about, how long was it, baby? A few weeks later, I'm driving her to work. And she started throwing up on the highway, going across the bridge to Prudential. I had to stop the car. She hung her head out the window. And then we had to start taking a bag with us. Because every time we got on the bridge, it happened. And so I went to work one day. I was on my job. I'm going to tell the whole story. We in the bed. And she crawled across me. She said she had heard that she crossed me. I have some of the morning sickness. And she crawled across me. And I got to work and I was sitting on a barrel. And I got so nauseated, so sick.
But I had to hurry up and retract that because he had to work.
And I ran to the bathroom, couldn't get there fast enough, and leaned over a barrel. And I came home and I said, what did you do to me? But listen, what happened? God honored our prayer. Amen. And not only did she become pregnant, but after the 9 months, it was a boy. God keeps his word. Yes, and God has no respect of person, baby. God has no respect of person, baby. Sometimes you feel like you're all by yourself. And you feel like God will help everybody but you.
I know.
You hear the testimonies of others. And you think that you are left all alone. You are not. You are not.
Has anybody ever been there? Bishop is talking about, but have you ever been, if you've ever been there, raise your hand and say, I've been there.
Yes.
Come on, tell Bishop, I know what you're talking about.
Yes.
We all have been there.
All have been there.
But we had to trust God. But you know what? Before Bishop go any further, this hit my mind. Let me say this. Let me get this straight right now, y'all. Let me straighten. Bishop said we got $1 million in the bank. That was just a little story that he was telling. You know how you compare things, so you won't go out and say that was that. Okay, so you won't go out. And say, but now look, if there's anybody out there and you're looking to sow a seed in fertile ground, we need a new. What we need, a chiller.
A chiller.
We need a chiller. And I've been asking God, give us some big money. So if there's anybody out there, I just had to say that, Bishop.
Right,
I just had to say that because they say, oh, they got $1 million in the bank. They don't need no help. No, he was just making a little comparison
yes,
there.
Yes, yes.
Amen. So yep. If anybody out there, write it out to All People International Church or APIC for short.
Yes.
And just put down there for the chiller.
Amen. Amen. And we'll give you a tax papers. For your donation. God bless you, saints.
Glory
listen,
to God.
I want to, I'm going to get it.
Hallelujah.
I want to say this to each of you.
Yes, sir.
Those who view us virtually, and those of you who are here in attendance.
Yes, sir.
I thank God for you.
Yes.
And I thank God for the word he's placed in our hearts for these past few weeks.
Yes, sir.
God keeps waking me up. He keeps talking to me.
Yes.
I keep hearing songs about trusting God.
Yes.
Hearing preachers preach. A young boy, I don't think he was 14 years old.
My God.
But he was on the internet. Mm-hmm. And baby pointed it to me. And for about 20 minutes or so, he encouraged the saints, the believers,
yes,
just to trust God.
Trust God.
I don't know if any of y'all saw that. But it spoke volumes to me because I believe that God sends out a universal word to believers. There are certain times when God has a message. You know, God has set us to praying.
Yes, sir.
The times we come together in prayer in the morning and then again at 6 o'clock, there's a purpose for that. Because anytime God is about to move,
hallelujah,
he sets his people to prayer,
yes, sir,
to praying. And I believe in my heart when God says to us, trust him.
Trust him.
When God asks us the question, can he trust us to trust him?
Yes,
he's getting us ready for what he's about to do. The Bible teaches us that when God makes up his yule,
yes, sir,
that he will remember those who trusted him, who had faith in him.
Yes, sir.
The same way a father remembers a son who has pleased him, who has served him.
Yes.
Listen, saints, let's purpose in our hearts to trust God, to serve God, to do those things that God has appointed to our hearts to do right,
yes,
to live holy, and to trust him,
yes,
in all things.
All things.
If you can do it, God will bless you. Listen, and don't you dare let anything come before God.
All right.
Don't allow anyone to say anything that draws you away from God. The deeper you get in trouble, the greater the sickness in is. It should not move you from God, but it should bring you closer to God. Understanding his love, his mercy, his kindness, and the truth of his word to heal you no matter where you are. I wish I had somebody in here. They can just clap your hands right now and give God glory, honor, and praise just for who he is. Well, Bishop, I believe in my heart. I want to thank God again for my precious baby and the strength he's given back to her. I believe that we have presented to you what God has said to us. God has said to us. Bishop, God has blessed us.
Yes.
There is a scripture that Paul writes.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
He talks about the love of Jesus Christ, of God, toward us. And that deep love that he has for us is an unfailing love. And we can't let anything, any situation, any hurt, any pain, any sickness, we can't let it separate us from the power of the love that Jesus Christ has for us.
Yes, sir. Paul says, for I am persuaded, hallelujah, that neither death nor life,
yes,
nor angels,
yes,
nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height,
yes,
nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus.
If you separate yourself from his love, where you gonna go? Who you gonna run to?
Yes.
God's arms are wide open to you, Facebook friends.
Yes, sir.
To you, members in this house. Mm-hmm. His arms are wide open. And he says to each of us, whosoever will, let him come.
Yes.
It's prayer time.
Yes.
Will you stand right where you are? Casting all our cares upon him, for he careth for us. How many know that God cares about you? If you know that God cares about you, stretch your hands toward the heavens. O eternal and everlasting Father, we humble ourselves. We bow our heads in reverence and honor, in respect to you.
Hallelujah.
You are our God.
Yes.
You are the creator of all that is seen and unseen.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are the lover of our lives. You are the peace that surrounds us when our minds stay on you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are the dawn. You're the way maker. You're the blesser. God, you are everything that we need. So God, here we are. Sometimes full of questions. Often misunderstood. But Lord, we love you. And sometimes through our action, we don't know how to show it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Saints, can you lift your hand and say, Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
So Lord, we pray today that in each of our lives that you, God, would deal with those things that we can't deal with.
Yes, yes.
There are things, God, we just can't deal with. Fix that, God, in us that we cannot fix ourselves.
In the name of Jesus.
We ask you in faith. And God, deliver us, God, from those things we cannot deliver ourselves.
Yes.
We trust you to do it. And God, if we have fallen in any way, please, God, pick us up, God, from anywhere we have fallen.
Jesus.
God, thank you for your love.
Thank you for your love.
Thank you for your kindness.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for your compassion.
That's
renewed every morning. God, great is your faithfulness toward us.
Yes, yes, yes.
And so, God, we count you as our shepherd.
Thank you, Jesus.
That will lead us, God, in the green pastures.
Hallelujah.
Let us rest beside still waters.
Yes, God.
And the rod of your staff comforts us. And you, God, the one who prepares a table before us in the presence of our enemies.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we know this, God, while you lead us, goodness and mercy shall follow us.
Thank you, Jesus. Jesus.
And we say thank you.
Thank you.
There are times, God, when I woke up in the morning and I just needed some of your mercy because things just didn't go right.
Jesus.
And there have been days, God, when I experienced so much of your goodness, I had to clap my hands and praise you. But in it all, God, I felt your presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Saints, can you lift your hands and say, God, I felt your presence.
God, I felt your presence.
And we say thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now,
thank
God, continue to bless us and to help us.
Yes, Lord.
Let your word, God, ever grow in us, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Let our faith and our trust in you, God,
in
grow every day. And let it be greater today than it was yesterday. And greater tomorrow than it is today. It is the prayer, God, of your servants.
Yes.
Bless our homes, our sons, our daughters,
yes,
our husbands,
yes,
our wives.
Yes.
Bless our,
yes,
neighborhoods, God,
yes,
in the name. And God,
oh, God.
God, forgive the wickedness of our nation.
Jesus, Jesus.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
And God, keep us in peace.
Yes, God.
It is the prayer of your servant.
Jesus.
And God, when trouble comes, and it will, when trouble comes, hide us in your pavilion.
Yes, God.
In the secret places of your tabernacle, hide us.
Hide us.
And we give you glory.
Glory,
we give you honor.
Hallelujah.
And we give you praise. Now, God, let the unchurched be church.
Yes, God.
Let backsliders be reclaimed.
My God.
Let the weak claim their strength. This is my prayer.
Yes, God.
It is my faith. It is that is sealed in my heart.
Thank you.
And I trust you to do it.
Trust you.
In Jesus' name, thank God.
Thank God.
Amen. Amen.
You know, there's an old song. Our musician might not even know it, but I just want to sing a little bit because it's ringing in my ears. I trust in God. Wherever I may be,
yes, yes, yes,
upon the land or on the roaring sea, though billows roar,
say it,
He'll keep my soul. The heavenly Father watches over me. I trust in God.
Yes, yes.
I know He cares for me.
Got to know it. Got to know it.
On mountain's peak.
or on the roaring sea. Though billows roar, he keeps my soul. The heavenly Father watches over me. How many of you trust him? I trust in God.
Yes.
I know he cares for me on mountain's peak or on the roaring sea. Though billows roar, he keeps my soul. My heavenly Father watches over me. Hallelujah.
Come on, you know songs. He's a wonderful God. Turn to your neighbor and say, he watches over me.
Yes.
He watches over me. From there you've seen and unseen, he watches over me. Do I have anybody here that knows that a son of a daughter, God has been protecting you? God's protecting you from some things you didn't even know the devil's trying to do. Can you give God a praise for that right now? He is a wonderful God. He is a mighty God. Can you make some noise? Thank God for them and the word that God has given them. Come on, stand to your feet. Thank you, our leaders, our chief apostles, our bishop Sherman, and thank God for that word.
It's a wonderful God. Bishop Sharon didn't show any signs of being recovered from sick addiction. I thought one time she was going to jump up and start moving. She started going, I'm like, you better preach. Thank God for being healed. Lift your hand if you know God is a healer. Thank God for being a healer. God bless you today, beloved. We hope something's been said or done to be a source and strength to help you of these days, months, and weeks to come. Know that God is for you. He's not against you. You are the apple of his eye. And he has your best interest at heart. Amen. Beloved, it's time to give. I said again, it's time to give. One more time, I can't hear you. It's time to give. It's time to give out there in Facebook land. It's time to give. It's time to be a blessing to the house of God. Amen. God has afforded all of us some type of job or income. Listen, he gives us 100% of a job, and he just requires that we return back to him. We return it back to him because all came from him. We return it back to him just 10%. Of that, and when we return that 10%, he allows us to do things with that 90%, beloved, that we never even dreamed possible. Can I get a witness right there? Listen, he feeds us, he clothes us, he takes care of all of us. So let's give today, beloved. Let's give our tithes. I've returned that tithe and offer to the Lord. Give that free will offering. Our chief apostle asks it every week. Our members and visitors alike on Sunday morning, give an offering of at least $20, beloved. Get that $20 out right now. Let's be a giver right now. And if you have a need to sow seed, but this is fertile ground. Couple of ways, beloved, you can give. The first way, it's through our website. That website name is www.allpeopleint.org. Go to our website there. You'll see give. Click on give. It'll take you right through the directions on how to give from the website. The second way, beloved, is through Givelify. I hope by now, if you have a smartphone, you've already downloaded the Givelify app. So, I mean, most of you in here, you give your offering, pay your tithes throughout the whole week. Lift your hand if you know that's the best way to do it. Let me go ahead and give God his money right now. Let me go ahead and get it out of my account and give it to him right now. So thank you. If you have that Givelify, if you don't have it downloaded, that is Givelify. That's right here. Givelify. Givelify downloaded. In the search field there, type in All People International Church. Our zip code is 32208. You'll see a picture of our chief apostle, Bishop Sharon, and you'll see our church logo. You'll know you're in the right place, all right? The third way to give electronic, beloved, is through the Cash App. We all like to hear that cha-ching. The Cash App. Our Cash App handle is $APIC.
APICJAX. Again, that is $APICJAX. God bless you. And of course, beloved, if you're here in the congregation today and you want to give in person, of course, you can pay by check, money order, cash, whatever you have. Remember, if you're paying by check, no envelope is needed. And as you exit out today, there are four places you can drop that offering. There are boxes on both sides of the exits, and there are also two boxes right here in the front. Feel free to drop that tithe and offering in there. All right? Come on, right there on Facebook. Give right now. Give, and it shall be given unto you. The word says, press down and shaking together. And I love how my ghetto Bible says it. It says, blessings will be dumped into your lap. They'll dump it. How many want some blessed God to be dumped in your lap? Right there on Facebook, type in, dump it, Lord. Dump it, dump it. In this house, make some noise if you want God just to dump some blessings in your lap. I want you just to dump some stuff in my lap in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for your giving. We appreciate your giving. Thank you so much for your giving. Beloved, please keep a few of our members in your prayers. Please keep Sister Reynolds in your prayers. She lost her oldest son on this week. Please keep her lifted up. You know, she's a part of our nursing guild. Please keep her lifted up. We thank God for what he's doing in our family. We have lost some people, and we pray for those family. But just like we lost some, God has healed some. Can we give God glory right now just for his healing power? We've had these last few weeks, the truth of the matter is we've had a great number of members who had COVID. Some were in the hospital, some was home, but God is bringing them back home by his power. Can you give God praise for that right now? Thank God for his healing power, for he is our healer. Listen, so make sure you stay protected. Make sure that every week, beloved, as you come to church, make sure you register. It's important that you register. We have to do this for contact tracing. It is very important that you register. We have to know who's in this building every week, all right? And although we do not have assigned seats, raise your hand if you sit in about the same seat every week. Go ahead, wave your hand. All right. We do not have assigned seats. Do you hear what I'm saying? We do not have assigned seats, but sit where you're sitting at right now every Sunday, okay? That makes sense. We don't have so if you get here, there's a visitor in your seat, do not pull them things my auntie used to pull. Y'all know my auntie. I love my auntie so much. Sister Myra Brown, get out my seat. You must don't go here. That's my seat. All right, don't pull them things, all right? But try your best every Sunday, wherever you're sitting there right now, try your best to sit there, because I know, I can look over the church every Sunday. I know exactly who's here, who's not here, based on where you sit. So when we're doing contact tracing, that's important for us, that if someone around you gets sick, we'll be able to notify you that something's going on, because that is required by law, okay? So we need you to register, so we'll know who's here, and please kind of stay in those same seats that you're in, because we have to do a contact tracing. We can do that. But thank God from Jesus, we can say this, no one has got sick from all people thus far. Can you give God some praise right now? No one has got sick from coming into this house. So we thank God for that, and we want that to continue in Jesus' name. Say amen. All right, so make sure let's do that. Remember to wear your mask at the social distance when you're exiting and when you're leaving it, all right? Last thing, we're out of here. Remember the Rice Drive. Haiti is going through so much right now. In the last few months, their president has been assassinated. Hurricane has wiped them out. First earthquake came through, and right after the earthquake, hurricane came through and did some serious damage. So let's keep them in, first of all, in our prayers, all right? But listen, how many of you know that God has called us as people and believers to do more than just pray? Can I get a witness? You do read your word, right? You do. God said, why are you praying for things that you can help people with? If I come to you and I say I'm hungry, don't be talking about Father God in the name of Jesus. God, please bless them and make them full. No, if you have means to feed me, it is your job and your responsibility as a believer to feed me. That's the word, all right? Listen, don't be around here praying for stuff you can do. Lord, feed them. I'm cold. Ooh, God, I pray right now that you cut a heater on around them. No, you got about 10 jackets. Give me a jacket. All right, listen, that's the word of God. So let's give. Bring it down some. If this is how you do it. If you do it through Givelify, there is something that says Haiti Rice Drive. In Givelify, there should be an envelope. Someone check that right now. It's not there. Oh, I promise I cut it on last week. It's not there. It will be on there in a minute. As soon as I get back to my phone, I make sure it's there. I thought I put it there. I must have messed up. I'm sorry. So I make sure it's there right now. It's at the top. It's there now. Okay, so if you go to, it says set the top. So as soon as you go in, it should be there. I'll check it and make sure, but it should say Hated Rice Drive. Oh, that's trending everywhere. Okay, yeah, so yeah, make sure you go to our page. And